This plane is being flown by a stunt pilot of Jordan's world-class aerobatics team, the Royal Falcons. They've been seen at air shows. Thank you.
looking at the owner of one of the very few outside of just the solo, Omar Bilal.
Gap between the people who came in the first 10 points is very, very close indeed. The accuracy.
Yeah. Now the solo Falcon, Omar Bilal, repositions his extra 300 because he's going to fly in for a thrilling opposition maneuver against his three teammates who will be coming in from the left as Omar flies directly towards the formation. Will he go below them, or is it actually right through? Now a loop in line abreast formation from the three aircraft. Line abreast is very difficult for the wingmen. Put yourself in their place. Just try looking straight to your left or right over your shoulder. Now imagine being in that position at over 150 miles an hour as the earth and sky gradually change places, and with another aircraft within a few feet of you. Now the difficult join-up maneuver. Omar has to judge his speed very carefully as he has no air brakes and the extra is a very aerodynamic, that means slippery, aircraft. But there he is, safely slotted into the number four position. And as the formation turns, we get the opportunity for a close-up of this high-performance aircraft. Number four position. And as the formation turns, we get the opportunity for a close-up of this high-performance aircraft. Designed in Germany by Walter Extra for unlimited aerobatics, the aircraft has found fame all over the world and is the steed chosen by the current British aerobatic champion and her, yes, I said her, predecessor. And here, demonstrating what is meant by unlimited class aerobatics, is Royal Jordanian Falcon solo pilot, Omar Bilal. The extra 300 is so called after its 300 horsepower six-cylinder Lycoming engine, which gives a maximum speed of 220 knots. The extra is stressed to plus and minus 10 G, but I've yet to meet a pilot who is. There, a rolling circle in which the aircraft describes a circle over the sea while rolling at the same time. Very disorientating indeed. Now this next sequence is a good one for the video camera enthusiasts in the audience, as Omar pushes up from the inverted into a tail slide and falls out of the maneuver, hammerheading towards the ground. The wires protruding from the wingtips are there to give the pilot an accurate reference point because he actually sits aft of the wing and so can't differentiate the vertical, the horizontal, or the 45 degree line. But they're of little help in this next maneuver, a lomchavac, named after the slang Slovak word for a large, stiff drink. Apparently, a Czech pilot once likened the sensation of flying this maneuver to the feeling you get after drinking several plum brandies. The pilots of the Royal Jordanian Falcons are selected from the elite of the Air Force, although the team is actually a full-time civilian formation aerobatic team. Formed in 1976 upon the initiative of King Hussein, it has an international reputation for precision, professionalism, and spectacular performance, which Omar Bilal is truly living up to today. After selection, the pilots undergo extensive training, usually consisting of 6 months of basic, intermediate, and then advanced aerobatic instruction, after which they're ready to put on a display that is truly memorable.
Number 10, Rouge. Number 9, Laporte. Number 8, Blanchot. Number 7, Buckingham. Number 6, Perry. Number 5, Meyer. Number 4, McDonald. Number 3, Van Overvest. Number 2,